You have got to be kidding me. They took the bait completely off the trap and did not set the trap off. This is the second time this has happened. Hello everybody, that's me, Tony, and my wife, Jill, and together we are rolling with the Bolins. So in 2017, we decided to give up the normal stick and brick life for a life of adventure on the road. So now we are nomadic and living full-time in our RV, so come along with us as we travel the world and get ourselves into all kinds of adventures. Okay, guys, what do you do when you've been outsmarted by Senor Mousy? This is ridiculous. We have been trying to catch this mouse for several weeks now. We have one mouse. We've watched him run across the floor. We've even caught him on a glue trap. And this sucker bit his own tail off to get away. Now, as you guys seen here at the beginning, he's taken the bait off of the regular kill trap, the old spring-loaded trap, without setting these off. Now, you can barely touch this thing and it will snap your finger. This little sucker's smart. So, like I said, we've been going several different ways of trying to get rid of this mouse. We've also used different kinds of deterrents like dryer sheets, the mint oil, and all these things here. They're supposed to be natural ways to keep mice out. The Irish Spring under in the bays. This little sucker ate a 30-pack of toilet paper. Not just one little roll. He ate a piece out of every one of them. Don't you know, toilet paper's hard to come by right now. And this little sucker ate my toilet paper. Not very happy about this. Not to mention the mess they make inside your RV, getting into things. And you hear them digging around at night. You don't know if you're going to wake up with one crawling across your face or any of that crap like that. So you got to get a little smarter than the mouse. Well, I've got smarter than the mouse this time. I glued the cheese to the damn trap. So that way, he had to fight with it. So we got him this morning. Poor Miss Jill didn't realize I had put the trap out there and caught him. She went to reach for something to make coffee this morning, and there was Senor Mousy caught in the trap, head first, eyes bugged out, looking at her like, what's up? Needless to say, she was not pleased this morning. But, so, I guess the thought of trying to get rid of the mouse is you're going to have to get a little smarter, because some of these little critters are damn smart. Like I said, it's been several weeks I've been trying to catch this mouse. Now, you know, that's part of life when you're in an RV or you're in places, the woods, campgrounds, they mow the grass. Critters want to try to get into your RV, and that's just the way it's going to work. They're going to try to find any kind of food, whether you pick stuff up, and they're a big fan of dog food, just so you all know. So if you have a dog, cover that crap up. Matter of fact, this sucker had made it into our bay, and we have an inflatable kayak. Now, everything's in a package. Well, this little sucker got in, and he filled the tubes for the paddle full of dog food. And so all this stuff has to be clean, sanitized, and all that stuff, because, you know, this is vermin. It does carry disease. So that's one thing. Having a mouse really sucks, especially when you can hear them, you can't catch them. And you're constantly a battle, washing all your stuff, washing your dishes. You know, they get into your drawers where your silverware is, and they take poop. So, you know, silverware gets expensive because, you know, cleaning it still doesn't feel very sterile, you know. So you end up throwing a lot of that stuff away. Pots, pans, gets in there, wreaks havoc. They even crawl around in your oven. Nasty, nasty, nasty. But it happens. It's part of RV life. But, like I said, we glued the cheese. We glued the cheese to the trap. That did the job. We tried peanut butter. Well, like I said, on the glue traps, they would actually get on the glue trap, steal the bait, and get away. I've never had a mouse do that. This mouse was smart. You know, fat little sucker too, because we saw him when he was small, and he had pretty much doubled in size by the time we caught him this morning. So he'd been over here at the Bolins at the smorgasbord having a buffet every night when we'd go to bed. So kind of felt bad about having to squish him with the trap like that. I like to have caught him in a way that he possibly could have got out and ventured on with his life in somebody else's world or just go someplace else, just out of the RV. But you left me no choice. I can be mean when I have to be. But anyway, guys, so just want to share with you guys a little bit of the mouse thing. You know, they say all these things work as far as using the dryer sheets, using the mint oil. But some of them are deterred from that. And we really have never had a real problem with mice the entire time we've been full time. Except for in the winter time, you kind of get one or two, maybe here and there, depending on where you're at. If you're in the woods, of course, they're going to get in. They're looking for warmth to live. But we had tried several different ways of catching it. And like I said, that was what ended up having to work ultimately. But, you know, the other remedies, you know, if you guys might know some other remedies, you guys want to share that with the rest of us out here, we'd all be grateful. Because, you know, if you had some good information that I could have used before all this, that might have been definitely something I could have used before I had to glue the damn cheese to the trap and try not to get the thing to flip over and smash my fingers. But what I ended up doing was, like I said, gluing it to the trap inside there where just enough of the cheese was sticking out for it to get a little nibble on it. Then, of course, I made that trap so sensitive that you barely blowed on it the wrong way, it would kick and catch whatever was there. But, you know, like I said, guys, this is one of those things that happen in RV life. You're going to have rodents. You're going to have ants. And this year, we've done with the rodents. And we had a little ant problem when it started getting warm. But I think that the campground where we're at, they put us on an ant hill. And they weren't very happy of us disturbing their little property. So, you know, we had to tell them, hey, look here, man, rent's due on the first month. Y'all didn't pay it. Y'all ain't going on this electric bill. Y'all got to go. So, leave it down in the comments, guys. Hopefully this helped tell you that, hey, sometimes you got to think outside the box and glue your cheese to the trap. This is the first one for me, but effective. So next time, guys, this is Tony. I'm going to talk to you guys soon. Bye.